Hi, Vikishan. Thanks for coming at short notice.
Well, thank you for having me.
Well, let me cut to the chase. Every year, we've been losing the basketball game to the geologists. We better figure this out. This had better be the last year.
I know, they keep rubbing it in our faces, and they're also very obnoxious.
Did you know that Joe is a geologist?
Why did geologist's wife leave him?
I don't know, Joe, why.
Because he took her for granted!
No, it was news to me and my classmates. He never once brought it up.
This had better be the year that we win and bring glory back to Fisher. So I charge you to put together that winning basketball team.
Well, thank you for trusting me with this. I know exactly who to start with. We need a good GM that knows how to create a sustainable competitive advantage for our team for years to come. We need Jay Dial.
I'm honored you guys want me to run the team this year.
Well, we wanted to take a fresh look at this and see if we can get a win.
Well, I think our mistakes is that we haven't focused on the support staff and completely building out our team. First, we need to get Robert Lowne to handle negotiations. Look, I'm a strategy guy, and I need a person as my assistant GM that can get these players signed. He'll be able to figure out everyone's balance. Next is recruiting. We have our target set for this year, but I want to have someone looking for new talent for future years. I recommend we promote Julie Conrad to head of scouting. We need a good team manager so that the coach doesn't have to worry about all the operations.
I agree. I think we should go with AC on this one. Nobody knows operational efficiency like that guy. He'll make sure that everything is taken care of and the coaches don't have to worry about anything.
I agree.
So this sounds like a strong front office. What about the players?
Well, the first person we need to start with is the point guard. We need Roger Bailey. This guy's quick, he'll set the tempo of the team. At least he talks really fast. I assume he can run fast, too. Next is shooting guard. We lost our fan favorite, Ben Burke, to free agency, but it will give Wellman a chance to step out of the shadow and show us what he can do. The way he tosses a cell phone and markers from hand to hand, you know he has to have great ball handling skills. For small forward, we need to go with Richie. He's an old school guy, will be a voice on the court, give instant feedback to his teammates. Power forward should be Ankerman. This guy means business. He's a hockey guy and will push people around in the paint.
So I think we should get Sheridan as our center. He's a big, tough guy. He can get the rebounds and blocks in the paint.
Vakishin, let's leave the GM role to me. While picking Sheridan is not a bad choice, we should be picking Boyer. He's tall, big, will be a roadblock for any opposing guards trying to get to the basket.
Well, that leaves just the coach.
Here's the thing. I already hired the coach.
Wait, without talking to me?
This coach will be great. He's tough, he demands the best, he doesn't take crap from anyone. Nothing short of 100% is good enough for him. We need the one and only Coach Mata.
This is going to be great.
Hello, people. I'm here. What?
Wait, you meant this Mata? I thought you meant that Mata.
You're the last person I want to see, too. Okay, guys, let's have a good practice. Let's have a good practice.
Oh my god, this is awful. I thought you said these are the best guys that we have.
Vakishin, you've got to trust the process. Say, what do you call a group of basketball players?
Hello, welcome back to the game. For those just joining us, I'm Murphy Goodman.
And I'm Michael Mahoney.
Well, we've got a tied game of 5 seconds left. Who would have thought that?
Well, this is a talented group of players we have on the court today, so for me, it's really no surprise that this one's coming down to the wire.
Really? You saw that coming? I was watching this team practice about 2 months ago, and they were trash. Well, either way, credit must be given to first-year coach Professor Mata for getting the team to this point. Before we go back to the game, let's see how they got here.
Well, the game took a scary turn when Professor Wellman went down with a knee injury in the first half. He had to be treated by the team trainer, but he was back in time for the second half. Then, late in the game, the geologists caught a lucky break with a debatable travel call that was missed on Joe Borman. The rules experts are really going to have a fun time debating this one.
The players did not like that one, and Coach Mata almost got a tech for talking a little bit too spicy.
Fisher went up back by three on the next play when the geologists blew their defense, and Wellman went in for an easy layup. But then, the geologists responded with a three on their next possession to tie up the game, leaving Fisher to call a timeout just 5 seconds remaining in the contest.
Now let's go into the huddle.
Let's do a 1-3-1 zone. Coach, we're actually on offense right now.
Are we?
Yeah.
I lost interest in this an hour ago.
Okay, Anchorman, inbound to me. Boyer set a screen for Wellman. We'll get you the ball for the shot.